Welcome back to Ringside Stories. Feel free to like and share this video. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and hit that notification bell if you enjoy the content. In part one of the historic preview of the Wilder-Fury rematch, we went over a possible stoppage victory for the Gypsy King, and that regardless of his current KO percentage, as history has shown, Tyson Fury still has a chance to stop Deontay Wilder. In this video, we're making a case for the Bronze Bomber to win the Wilder vs. Fury 2 fight by decisive knockout. Before I reveal today's historical rematch, let's take a short trip to memory lane. Going into the first Fury fight, Wilder successfully defended his WBC title against Cuban Luis Ortiz, holding a perfect record of 40 wins, 0 losses, and 39 wins coming by way of knockout. Talks for a possible unification match with Anthony Joshua fell through, and by mid-2018, the heavyweight division was in a stalemate. In stepped Tyson Fury, who had never lost his belts inside of the ring and still was the lineal champion. However, coming off a near 3-year layoff and clearly still having to adjust, some boxing aficionados questioned Tyson Fury as a legit opponent for Deontay Wilder. That's why he took a lot of criticism, which made for entertaining press conferences.
Ready?
I'm always
full. I'm ready when you are, big
dog. Let's go.
Come on.
Let's go.
Come on, then.
Let's go.
I beat the best heavyweight in the last 50 years, my boy.
He beat himself.
I beat the best heavyweight in the last 50 years, my boy. The longest reigning heavyweight champion in history.
You only had one.
You didn't beat nobody. You beat a little bum. Fat bum.
And the birth of Wilder's infamous...
To this day.
The fight was another step up and proved to be a tough outing for Wilder. Although he had some fair success in the early rounds, overall Wilder had trouble dealing with Fury's herky-jerky style, failing to catch him clean as the Bronze Bomber was headhunting and spending most of his energy looking to knock Fury's head off. Critics will say that Wilder was exposed, that he fought a Fury at 60% of his game, and that the Fury who dismantled Vladimir Klitschko in 2015 wouldn't even have hit the canvas against Wilder. Is that so? So far, Wilder has been able to at least knock down or stop every opponent he's faced. And people should take note that landing that right hand is a skill in itself, and it only takes one shot, as history shows. March 17th, 1990, what would be Ring Magazine's Fight of the Year. The light welterweight unification bout between IBF champion Meldrick the Kid Taylor and WBC champ Julio Cesar Chavez in what was titled Thunder Meets Lightning as an allusion to Taylor's dazzling hand speed. A fantastic amateur pedigree with 99 wins and just 4 losses, capturing Olympic gold in 1984 at the age of 17, who had a pro record of 24 wins, 0 losses, and 1 draw. Versus Chavez, who was known for his accuracy and punching power that led him to 55 KOs in his 3-weight world title run, with a record of 68 wins and 0 losses going into the Taylor 1 fight. The winner would get the spotlight of everything below the heavyweight division. Prior to the bout, Chavez hadn't fought a fighter like Taylor and got into his range like a walking target. Chavez's offense was nullified, simply being outmaneuvered, outboxed, and outclassed for the first 9 rounds of the fight. Nevertheless, El Cesar del Boxeo stuck to his bread and butter by staying in the pocket, willing to take 4 shots for 1 of his own in return. And in the championship rounds, Chavez's grit and power started to take toll on the Kid Taylor, which everybody in the crowd, including the commentary team, were glancing over. And then in the 12th round, after being down on 2 of the 3 judges' scorecards, Chavez persevered and hit Taylor with his signature right hand. Referee Richard Steele stopped the fight with only 2 seconds left in the fight.
Unbelievable! Richard Steele stopped the fight with fewer than 5 seconds to go!
2 seconds. Where have we heard that before?
I always say these guys have to be perfect. They have to be perfect. For 12 rounds, I only have to be perfect for 2 seconds. And each and every time, I proved that.
Just like Chavez in 1990, Deontay Wilder was fighting for the lineal championship, going up against a superior boxer who was undefeated, who showed a warrior's mentality, and who was outpointing him for the majority of the fight, showing perseverance by dropping his man hard in the 12th that had many boxing fans talking long after. In both instances, the rematch between puncher and classical boxer was just a matter of time. rematch on September 17, 1994 produced fireworks yet again, with both light welterweight savants slugging it out, continuing where they ended 4.5 years prior. Coming into round six, where Taylor hit Chavez with a low blow, leaving him behind on the scorecards. Halfway through the round, Chavez staggered the kid, whose chin and heart were tested once more. Taylor decided to go toe-to-toe with the Mexican slugger, a strategy which would later backfire on him. In the eighth round, Chavez countered the lazy lead straight with a perfectly placed left hook upstairs. Taylor would beat the count, yet failed to stop Chavez's onslaught seconds after. This time, there will be no controversy. Round 8 was the round Meldrick Taylor predicted a KO. Ironically, it was Julio Cesar Chavez that made that prediction become a reality. 26 years later, Tyson Fury has made his prediction for the Wilder 2 fight.
Two rounds, he's going down.
Can Wilder repeat history by turning Fury's prediction around with a KO of his own? The fact that Fury reconnected with the Detroit Krunk Gym might be proof of him going for an early finish. But won't that be just playing into Wilder's hand? Keep in mind that in the Wilder Fury 1 fight, Wilder was a bit fatigued in the 12th round, which might have dampened his power. So far in the build-up, there haven't been many pressers, which could be an advantage for Wilder. Even though Wilder is loud,
Bomb Squad!
He is simply no match in the verbal arena for Tyson Fury.
Y'all don't have the experience that I have in this.
I know, because he has the experience to get knocked out in the amateurs. I didn't get knocked out in the amateurs.
You ain't ready. You're not ready, Dawson, are you? You big bum.
So since the Tyson Fury antics have been minimalized for the upcoming Fury Wilder 2 fight, will Deontay Wilder now perform better? Remember, in the buildup of the first fight, Fury had taunted Wilder with every chance he got and continued his antics inside the ring, forcing Wilder to throw power shots pretty much from the opening bell, making himself look very one-dimensional and missing the majority of his shots. Although his opposition in 2019 weren't elite level, the Bronze Bomber has showed improvements since the Fury 1 fight. Wilder has become more patient, i.e. remains calm even if he gets thoroughly outboxed and is down on the scorecards by a landslide. He straightened up his money punch even more, and his record shows that Wilder is indeed dangerous throughout the whole fight. And no matter what you say about Wilder, as long as he lands, he'll send his opponent to the canvas.
Deontay Wilder is the most fiercest puncher in boxing history, in heavyweight division history. And I saw that tonight, I felt it.
Miraculously, Tyson Fury managed to finish the fight, becoming only the second fighter to go the full distance with Deontay Wilder. History has shown that a puncher can end his opponent's ambition with piercing power.
Going to the head, down goes Taylor!
Will Wilder be able to repeat his Mexican predecessor's accomplishment, leaving it out of the judge's hands by stopping his rival Fury, and shut up all of his critics by staying undefeated and becoming lineal heavyweight champion in the process? Now, if you're one of those folks that count Deontay Wilder out because of his inferior skill set, because of his lacking technique, just remember, every fighter has a puncher's chance. Deontay Wilder happens to be the pure definition of a puncher's chance.
Bam, baby, good night.
So will Wilder knock out Tyson Fury? Let me know what you think. Drop a comment below and let's have a conversation. Feel free to like and share the video. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and hit that notification bell if you enjoy the content. This is Boxing's Objective Observer with Ringside Stories. Thanks for watching and have a legendary day.